Welcome you all to this class. Today we are going to do exercise 1.2 of class 10, chapter 1, real numbers. Exercise 1.2. This is based on the concept of a fundamental theorem of arithmetic, that means the prime factorization of a composite numbers. So let's do the question number 1. Express each numbers as a product of prime factors. So question number 1 is 140, then second question is 156, then third number is 3025, and fourth number is 5005, fifth number is 7429. So you have to solve this. These are very basic things. You can do them easily if you practice the divisibility rules in your previous classes. So at first we have to consider 150. So we can do it by different methods. So it will be the more familiar method. 2 7 14 and 2 0 0. 2 35. This is actually dividing the numbers. So here, after 2, the divisibility rule of 3 is, if the addition of the sum of the numbers 5 plus 3 means 8 is not divisible by 3, so it will not be divisible by 3. But then again the prime number is, next number is 5, and it can be divisible by 5. So we get only 4 prime numbers, 2 into 2 into 5 into 7, which can be expressed as 2 squared, 5 to the power 1 and 7 to the power 1. We can write the powers 1 or not. Now we will solve the second question, that is 156. So by the divisibility of a rule 2, we can solve this. 2 7 is 14, remainder is 1, 16, 2 8 is 16, 2 3 is 6, remainder is 1, 8, 2 3 is 6, remainder is 1, 8, that is 18, 2 9 is 18. But here, this is not divisible by 2, then but it is divisible by 3, because 9 plus 3 is 12, 3 1 is 3, 3 3 is 9. So there are only 4 factors, 2 into 2 into 3 into 13. We can write this in this format, 2 square 3 into 13. There is no symbol on these numbers, that means the power is 1. Now question number 3, 3025. So this is not divisible by 2, because here 5 is present. Also it is not divisible by 3, because the sum of the digits is 3 plus 2 5, 5 plus 5 10. So we have to go for the next prime, that is 5, 2 3 5. So by dividing 5, we get here 5 6 are 30, and here as the divisor is a single digit, so we have to divide it with the single digit 2, that means 5 0 is 0. So here we get 2 and then remainder 2, then 5, 25. So 5, 5 is 25. Again it will be divisible by 5. 5, 1 is 5. Then 1 and 0, 5, 2 is 10. 5, 1 is 5. And 121, it is divisible by 11. Because by the rule of, divisible to rule of 11, we have to add these two numbers. 1 plus 1 is 2 and 2 minus 2 is 0. So it is divisible by 11. So there are only 4 factors. 3025 is equal to 5 into 5 into 11 into 11, that is 5 squared and 11 squared. Next, fourth question, 5005. it is clearly divisible by 5. 5 1 the 5, 5 0 the 0, 5 1 the 5. Now, this is also divisible by 11, because 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1. When we differentiate 1 and between 1, we get 0, so it is divisible by 11. 11 9 the 99, remainder is 1 and 1, 11. So 11 1 the 11. And it is also divisible by 7. 7 because 13 7 the 91. So here the 5 factors are 5 into 7 into 11 into 13. All are single primes, no power. Now example 5. 7429. So it is not divisible by 2, not divisible by 3, 9 plus 2 is 11, 11 plus 15, 15 plus 7, 22. Then not also not divisible by 5 and 7, 7 1 is 7, not divisible by 7. Then 11, 9 plus 4 is 13, 7 plus 2 is 9, 13 minus 9 is 4, so not divisible by 11. Then 13, we have to divide it by 13. Whether it will be visible or by 30 or not. No, it is not divisible by 30. Then we go to the next prime, that is 17. Seven four is 68. 17 for the 60, 17 3 is 51, 17 7 is 119, so it's divisible by 17. How, and we get the result 437. Now we have to apply whether it is divisible by 17 or not. 17 2 is 34, 9, no, next prime is 19. So it is not divisible by 19. Now we will move to 23. 23. It is divisible by why it is not divisible by 19? 437 divided by 19. 19 2 is 38. Now 57. So 19 3 is 57. So it is divisible by 19. So the three factors are all are primes. Primes are 17 into 19 into 23. So this is one type of difficult problem. But you have to try all the divisible rules first. Then after 11, you have to divide manually without applying the divisible rule. Now we are going to do the question number 2. So what is question number 2? Find the LCM and HCF of the following pairs of integers. Find the LCM and HCF of the following pair of integers and verify that LCM into HCF is equal to product of the two numbers. So now we are going to do the question number 2. Find the LCM and HCF. Of the following pair of integers and verify that LCM into HCF is equal to A in the product of the two numbers. So first question is 26 and 91. Second question is 510 and 92. And third question is 336 and 54. Let's try to solve this. 26 is equal to 2 into 30. 91 is equal to 7 into 30. So HCF is the common and lowest power, that is 30. LCM is equal to 2 into 7 into 30. That means 2 into 91. 182. HCF into LCM is equal to 13 into 182. Now multiplying the numbers 26 into 91. That is also 2366. So this is verified. HCM into LCM is equal to product of the two numbers. So this is verified. Now we are going to do the second question. 510 is equal to, so we have to find out the prime numbers, prime factors. So you have to put all the divisible rules 1 by 1 in the ascending order. Five and ten is equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 17, and 92 can be expressed as 2 square into 23. So HCF only common is 2, smallest is 2. So here we can get the LCM by taking the highest powers. 2 square into 3 into 5 into 17 and into 23. So by multiplying these, we get the number 23,460. That is 46,920, and here we have to multiply the HCF and LCM. HCF is 2, LCM is 23,460. By multiplying these two, we get the same number. That means it is also verified. Now we will move to the third question. 336 is equal to, we have to factorize it. So there are 4, 2 to the power 4 into 3 into 7, 54, 2 into 27, that is 3 cube. So HCF, here 2 commons and lowest is 2 into 3, that is 6. And LCM, we have to take all the primes with their highest power. So 2 to the power 4, 3 cube into 7, that is 16 into 27 into 7. That is 3024. Now HCF into LCM, that is 6 into 3024. Six four the 24, 4 2, 6 2 the 12, 12 plus 2 14, 6 0 0 1, 1844. Now we have to multiply the two numbers to get the answer whether both are equal or not. So if you do all the calculations minutely or mindfully, you will every time get the correct answer. Otherwise you will be confused and always move in between these calculations. So always do the calculations mindfully so that your time will be set. So verified. It is also verified. So students, now let's do question number 3, exercise 1.2. Find the HCF and LCM. Find the HCF and LCM by prime factorization method. Question number 1 is 12, 15 and 21. Question number 2, that is 17, 23 and 29. Question number 3, that is 8, 9 and 25. So let's solve the question 1. 12 can be represented as 2 into 2 into 3, that is 2 square into 3. 15 is 3 into 5 and 21 is 3 into 7. So the common prime factor is 3 and its lowest power is also 3. So HCF of 12, 15 and 21 is equal to 3, and the LCM of 12, 15 and 21 is equal to, we have to take all the prime factors, 2 square into 3 into 5 into 7, 4 into 3 into 5 into 7, 420. So by this process we can also do the second problem. So 17, it is a self prime number. So as 17, 23 and 29, they can be expressed as 1 into 17, 23 is equal to 1 into 23 and 29 is equal to 1 into 29. As these are not composite numbers, so they can be expressed as the product of prime factors. So they are co-prime numbers and their HCF will be 1. because the HCF of a coprime numbers is always 1, and LCM is the multiplication of all the 3 numbers. So whenever we get coprime numbers, we know that the HCF is 1 and LCM is multiplication of those numbers. Similarly, we can also do the third question. Eight is equal to 2 cube, 9 is equal to 3 square, and 25 is equal to 5 square. There is nothing common in between these 3 numbers, so their HCF is also 1, and LCM is multiplication of these 3 numbers, 1800. So after solving this, we are going to solve question number 4. These questions are of the standard class 6, so you can easily solve these questions. Now move to question number 4. Given that HCF of 306 and 657 is equal to 9, then LCM of, we have to find the LCM. So we can apply the formula we have, or rule we have learned, that is HCF into LCM is equal to A into B. So here A is equal to 306 and B is equal to 657. And HCF is 9. So 9 into LCM is equal to 306 into 657. So LCM is equal to 306 into 657 divided by 9. So you will observe that the sum of these numbers, 6 plus 3 is 9, and this is 7 plus 6, 13 plus 5, 18. So both the numbers are divisible by 9. So you have to divide any one number by 9. So this product will give us the LCM, 657 into 34. So here we have to write 22,333. Now we have to do the question number 5. Check whether 6 to the power n can end with digit 0 for any natural number n. So its answer, so let's explain, 6 to the power n is equal to 2 into 3 whole to the power n. is equal to 2 to the power n into 3 to the power n. So in the prime factorization of 6, we get only 2 primes, 2 and 3. But in order to have 0 at the ones position or end, we must have both 2 and 5 as primes. So as here no 5 is so as we don't get 5 as prime, so we never get 0 at the end of 6 to the power n for any value of n. This is the answer. Now we will do question number 6. Explain why seven into 11 into 13 plus 13 and 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus 5 are composite numbers. Before going to the solution of this problem, we have to remember what are composite numbers. The numbers which are more than two factors, that are called composite numbers. That's when three or more. If that have only two factors, then that is called a prime number. And if more than two factors, then that will call as a composite number. So here let's take the first case, 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13. So 13 can be taken as common. Here we get 7 into 11 plus 1, that is 13 into 77 plus 1, or 13 into 78, which can be expressed as 13 into 13 into 2 into 3, or 2 into 3 into 13 square, as it is expressed as the product of primes. So it is a composite number. We can clearly mention the prime factors. It has 5 factors, out of them 3 are primes. Now We will solve the second problem. Seven into six into five into four into three into two into one plus five. So here we take five as common. So inside the bracket, 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 plus 1. So it gives 5 into 1008 plus 1. So 5 into 1009. Which is a prime number. So by so as it is expressed, as the product of two primes, so it is a composite number. Now it is clear. Now we move to question number 7. So now we are going to solve the question number 7. Here, there is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round of the field, while Robbie takes 12 minutes to complete one round. That means Robbie travels faster. Suppose they both start at the same point. This is the starting point. And at the same time and in the same direction. Sonia also moving in direction and Robbie also moving in this direction. After how many minutes they will meet again at the starting point? So as Robbie is faster, when Robbie completes one round in 12 minutes, Sonia is on the track. He doesn't complete one. She doesn't complete one round. That means they will not meet at the first round. Then after second round, third round, in this way they will meet. But we have to find the least time in which they meet at the starting point. For this, we have to find the lowest common multiple of 12 and 18. So that after that time, they will meet again. So 18 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3, that is 2 into 3 square. 12 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3, that is 2 square into 3. So in the LCM we have to take the highest powers. So they will meet at the starting point after 36 minutes again. Each 30 minutes, again 30 minutes, again 30 minutes. After each 30 minutes, they will meet at the starting point. So here, exercise 1.2 is completed. Thank you for watching the class.